Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to the new Reaper tips number 8. Today we're gonna go over the little rate slider that you can find in Reaper. This rate pretty much controls the speed of the playback head in your arrangements. So you can make your arrangement go very slow and just very fast. But not only that, you can do a bunch of really cool stuff with it, and I'm gonna show you right now in the video. So in here we have an original song that I composed using nothing but MIDI, and it kinda goes like this. So let's say that I'm not quite convinced with the BPM of the song right now. Let's say that I want it kinda slower now. I'm gonna drag the rate right here and just put it on 9. And let's hear how it sounds like. Nah, let's say that I want it faster now. I'll just drag this rate to 1.1. And it goes like this. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. So now the cool part is that you can apply this play rate to the current BPM of your song. You just need to go to the section of the song where you want your BPM change. In my case, I just want it in the beginning. So I'll go to the beginning and right click here and apply play rate to current BPM. And there you go, the BPM that you were looking for is 122, and you can now round up this number. That's awesome. One thing to keep in mind if you're doing music stuff, you need to right click here and enable the preserve pitch, so it's not gonna alter the pitch of your song if you go slow or fast. And if you play an instrument, this could be a really useful tool. So you can practice a song at 50% speed, 70% speed, and go from there. For example, there's this kinda tricky riff that you wanna learn for your song. Easy, just go for 50% first. Then you get a little cocky and you go for 75%. And then you do it 100% and you don't even realize this. So let's say that you're practicing this kind of complicated solo, and you don't even know if it's gonna sound good in the arrangement at the end. So you can put your project at like 75% speed and track your solo that way. And after you're done recording, just put it back to normal speed and listen how it sounds like. And if you like it, now you know that it's gonna sound good at the end. And now you just need to practice and record it at full speed. And now you can even use this for sound design, and it's awesome. Okay, so remember when I told you to enable the preserve pitch option? Now you're gonna disable it, and you're gonna see why. You're gonna go to the view menu and show master track. And now we're gonna automate the playback rate. So you're gonna click this icon right here and select play rate. Then close this window. This is how the original audio sounds like.
Isaac!
And now we can just place envelope points across the item.
Isaac!
And we can get super crazy results.
Isaac!
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 And you can just have a lot of fun with this. So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you have any questions, please let me know. And I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.